Hello kids, so today we are going to study science. In science, we are going to study something very special. And this is class 6, chapter 10 and very first session of ours. Okay, now the name of our chapter, it is NCERT, Motion and Measurement of Distance. Distance, you are acquainted of this word very much as you come from your school or from your home or from a marketplace. You cover certain amount of distance daily in your day-to-day life, even room to room. Now, before moving on to that topic, let me discuss you something. Do you like to go out in a picnic or somewhere? Do you enjoy yourself moving out of your premises? As vacations are there in school, during vacation, maximum kids with their parents go out for outing, for roaming, even to enjoy themselves. Sometimes people also go to the gathering. Family gatherings are their social gathering, we can say. As in a nuclear family, we doesn't have the time to meet with each other. Already we have only 4 members. Other members are living somewhere else in a village. So when there is some function, we all just gather around and enjoy ourselves in that particular occasion. So let me ask you, have you ever been a state visit? Have you ever been a state visit? Have you ever gone to somewhere which is little bit far from your home? I hope you would have gone. Just think of what have you used to just reach that place. Many kids would have gone through airways by aeroplane. When do we use that? When we have to go abroad to other country. Nowadays, airways are available for state to state, but it is very costly too. But you would have gone through air too. Secondly, there are other ways also. You would have gone by railways, means by train. Through train, it is very, very, very interesting trip. Why? Because from the window of train, we can see all around, many mountain comes, forest comes, it's very interesting. Many of you would have gone by road, as by your private vehicle like car, even by buses. So there are different means of transport which you can use for covering your distances. Just think of that and remember how interesting was it to go by airways, what have you seen, or railways, or bus. So what you have done in that, you have covered a shorter or a large amount of distance to reach to your destination. Destination means where you want to go. Now, in your chapter, the name is Motion and Measurement of Distance. Motion means movement, as I told you, to go somewhere, to reach somewhere. We have certain quality of moving, like sometimes we move straight, sometimes there is a road which has a zigzag formation. So these type of motions are also called uniform motion, non-uniform motion, rectilinear motion, circulation motions are there. There are many motions are there which we are going to study in this chapter. But later, right now, as per your NCERT science book, what's given, there is a story of transport. What had exactly happened in the story of transport? What do you mean by transport? Transportation is the vehicles only which are used to cover the distance. Distance like when you have to reach somewhere. And very easy and quick example is when you come from your home to school. Some kids come by bus, school bus, some by pedestrian, some by bicycle, bike, etc. This is a quick example of transportation. Now, have you ever thought of in ancient time what had happened? Do they have the vehicle facility? Do you have any idea? Yes, let me tell you that. No, they don't have any vehicle facility in our ancient time. They do all their work by barefooted only. They don't even have anything to cover their feet. Okay? So they move around the jungle on their foot and do all their work and even cover all the distances, not only the few. In kilometers, they walk by foot. Slowly, slowly, what had happened? The wheel invented. Since 19th century, there was not a particular invention took place. After that, steam engine came. Thereby, the trains acknowledged by the people. But in olden days, what do the people do? Kilometers, like 5 kilometers, even 20 to 25 kilometers, they just go by walk only on their foot. Even people uses animals, okay? People take the help of animals to cover up the distance as they sit on the back of animals as well as for carrying their loads. They uses animals. Thereafter, as wheel was invented very first as a part of transportation, then the people started using bullock carts. Okay, the carts are driven by the animals, and likewise the story of transport started. So from pedestrian first wheel invented, so carts were there, ox cart, bullock cart, thereafter steam engine, and then train come. Thereafter the transportation like airways, waterways, railways, roadways, everything come. Now among all these transportation system, there are difference among them. Difference like if we talk about railways, railways are cheaper than the airways. Airways we use when we have to do something quickly. Okay, we have to reach some place in a shorter period of time. Then we use as airways, but it is very bit of costly. Why? Because making an aeroplane, it's a big task. Crores of rupees are required to make the body of aeroplane. That's why it is the costliest among all the railways or airways or this thing, roadways. Among all this, the airways is the costliest one. The cheapest one is waterways. Why? Because mainly the boats are made up of wood, and wood we can get in our country very easily, and there is no fuel required. Okay, to run a boat there is no need of any fuel, so that is the cheapest one. So somebody asks you, so what is the cheapest means of transport? So in that situation the answer will be boat. Costliest it is aeroplane. Slowly, slowly, slowly people started understanding and started using the facility they are provided with. Even with the inventions, many difficulties of transportation have been shorted out even. So this was all about the story of transport. Okay, next, what do you have in your book? It's how far have you traveled? How wide is this gas? How far you have traveled? You would have traveled far, far away. As I used to travel a lot, I like to visit always new places. In every vacation, I just move out of my house just to explore new place. Not only, okay, why do we travel? What is the need of travel? We have a mind, okay? We have certain mental abilities. So if we move to new places, then only we can understand that there are the people around us, they want to understand us. they want to know about us. Even we can learn many things from them, that how to enjoy, as you will have a different types of people around you. You come to know different culture. You even come to know different ability and how you can survive in the situation sometimes which become very difficult even for our survival. As there are the people who sleep without the meal. How can they sleep? This, if you want to know, you have to explore. You have to move out of your comfort zone. Then only you can understand and you will be a good physically as well as mentally fit. You can understand your responsibility, necessity, and you will, or you can tell to your neighbors, even you can discuss with your friends that I've been to Darjeeling. Do you know what kind of place is Darjeeling? It is the place where there is 100% oxygen available. Okay, it's totally a green place. Everywhere greenery, you can say, and each and every people are bothered for the cleanliness of their particular area or the society. If somebody throws the paper onto the road, so other, the neighbors just go and pick it up. So on seeing this, we realize this. Okay? It's not just you just poke someone always. You can do a favor. You just pick it up. Doesn't matter who has thrown. It's your place. So once you have understood this, there is no issue at all. So when do we come to know that Darjeeling is such a place where 100% oxygen is there? When we went out for that place, in that situation, we understood, yes, in India we get a place like that. Even you have learned one good quality. The quality states that if somebody put the garbage outside the home, so it is not to wait, you can also clean it up. Think that it is your work to clean. Yes, you should advise the people not to do the garbage around, but at the same time, don't poke someone. So this was the story, okay, of what, of how we went outside and explored the new ideas. Now, have you ever measured at your height without the measuring tape? Have you ever? You would have, I know. So what you have used? You would have used your hand. How? From the tip of thumb till the tip of your little finger. You can measure like this. Okay? From here till here, it is a one hand span. You can measure like this. Okay? Suppose your mama has gone to a market, but you didn't go. Then you make a call to your mama, "Mama, kindly bring a shirt of blue color for me, a pair of shirt." So mama says, "Oh, I don't know exactly what your size is." And what will you do? You can quickly measure with the help of your hand span. It is not perfect, but you can just give the idea to your mother and she will buy accordingly. So sometimes we can measure by the help of our hand palm. In the same way, as you sit on your bench, you can even measure it with the scale. With what? With scale also you can measure by putting it. Suppose it gets over here. How will you measure it? Just see. You just put the scale on your desk. Make a mark over here. Okay? Again, just this. Like this, you can measure. Okay? And this will give you accurate measurement. Why? Because it is given over here. And this is called the scale measurement. It is a perfect measurement. But suppose you are playing with your friend in a class. So you say, "Okay, you tell me the width of your bench." Your other friend says, "You tell me your length." So what will you going to do? For a quick answer, you can have a measurement by the help of your hand. By taking a proper span, then you can say it has 7 span or 10 span, etc. So as in earlier time people doesn't know how to measure a thing, so they use such parts of the body for measuring. Okay, let's see now what we have in this chapter. That was all about measuring. Let's see on the board. Now very first is distance, the length of space between the two points. Means here you can see I have made a point, this is A and this is B. So the length covered between A and B is called distance. There should be a starting point as well as the ending point. If you know your destination, you have to calculate from the place you left till the place you reached. This is called distance. Next, measurement. We have just discussed about measurement. For accurate or perfect measurement, we have to use certain things, and there are their units also, names of their units. So suppose you can use, you have to measure a piece of cloth, so you can use scale. This is a centimeter scale, there are meter scale. When you go to a shop who sells cloth, okay, the fiber, so there what will you going to ask? You will going to ask, suppose 2 meter cloth of white color, the what he or she will do? He has a meter scale, this much long scale. He take a measurement, hear it and just give it to you and charge money for that. At that time, he will not going to measure it by the hand or foot, etc. Why? Because they cannot be the perfect one. If we deal with something for money, we have to give a perfect measurement. As you just move around, you have to go somewhere. Kolkata you have to go, or Delhi you have to go. So you don't have any vehicle, you ask for a cab or something. In that case, you have to pay even. So for paying, that always like, who asks? The person who is driving, the cabman asks, how much kilometers you have to cover? Suppose we have to cover 1500 kilometers. Then the cabman asks you, the driver will going to ask you the money for. It can be possible a 1 kilometer equals to 17 or 18 rupees. It depends upon the rate of petroleum. This was, I was telling you about the perfect measurement of the distance. Distance can be measured in meters or kilometers. We cannot measure the distance in liter. Why? Because liter and milliliter is basically used for liquid substance. In the same way, kilogram and gram, it is for weighing vegetable, cereals, etc. If you have to measure the distance, you have to use two things. First is kilometer and other is meters. Now, if you have to calculate the big distance, distance from city to city, town to town, even state to state or country to country, so it will be calculated in kilometer. But if you are measuring within your premises or measuring a cloth, do you get that? Sari. So you have to measure in meters. That is why meter is called the smallest unit of measuring a cloth. Understood? I hope this is quite clear to you. Let's see. So I hope this is quite clear to you. Now in ancient time, what does the people do? They have the measuring tape like tailor has? No, beta. Now what they do? Let's see. To find out size, amount or degree. Degree what? As summer is going on, so it's very hot outside. So we measure the temperature by the thermometer. When we have to calculate the atmospheric temperature, we use the thermometer which has Fahrenheit or Celsius. Which one do we use? Do you have any idea? We use in Celsius. When you have to calculate your body temperature at that time it deals with Fahrenheit. There is a thermometer inside it. Mercury is there. As the hotness of the body or the environment increases, that mercury also increases in size. Size in what way? It go upward. In summer, if we talk about Gujarat, temperature goes till 44 degree. Too much hot, even more than that. In country like Canada, the temperature always go in minus 15 degree, 20 degree. All over there is ice we are going to find. So likewise, we calculate the temperature of the atmosphere as well as inside our body. Temperature means fever. If you are suffering from fever, the temperature of thermometer changes. When it crosses, the mercury crosses 100 or more than 99, it means you have a temperature. Okay? Let's see. So, I hope degree is quite clear to you. Of something by comparing it with a standard is called measure. There should be some standard quality of measuring. Okay? We cannot guess. Okay, mama says, what is your height? You just fold your hand and say, mama, it can be possible that I am 4 feet or 6 feet. No, I mean, this is not called the measure. There should be certain possibility of accuracy. Then only you can suggest. Okay? So, what it says that size, amount or degree of something is comparing it with a standard is called measure. There should be some standard. The action of measuring. When we start measuring by any of the things, I can use even pen for measuring. Okay? So when we start measuring, this is process is called measurement. Now, what happened in ancient time? In ancient time, people don't know how to calculate the distance. So what do they use? They use their hand, their arm, then their foot to measure. For example, you can see. What do the people do? They use their foot, hand, etc. For example, these were the things. Length of arm. Arm. This is your arm. So you say now, how long it is? It takes 2 arms. Okay, the length. So the length of arm is also known as cubit. Length of foot. Foot, you use your foot for measuring. Length of your foot step. Single step. Okay, I'll give you the example. First you understand. In ancient time, what do the people use for measuring? Next, hand span. We have just given the example. This was the scale, but I just given the example as you were about to measure the size of your shirt. Okay? Use as units of length. Now let me give you an example for understanding a foot measurement nicely. You all like to play? Yes, I know. So when you play kabaddi, the names like kabaddi or any other, there is a, you play, girls likes to play one-legged game. This is a one-legged game. The whole ground is divided into different parts. Okay? We may have two column here, two column here. We can number it 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Now, by having one-legged, okay? One-legged, we start jumping from him to this side and sometimes we skip 1, 2, 3, 4. This is a game. In ancient time and nowadays also, girls like most to play the games like this. So, suppose they don't have any scale or measuring tape, then what they will do? They are going to take the measurement by the help of their foot. By foot, they can measure the distance and can make this type of shading onto the soil. As well as the boys. Boys like to play kabaddi very much. Now suppose they have to made the ground. Though there is a specific measurement of kabaddi, but when you play with your friends, when you are not playing professionally, use your foot, just make the ground. Just divide it into two parts. Here the participants can stand. Even here can the participants stand. There is no particular measurement done. Still, you are able to make by the help of the things which are available with you. It cannot be the accurate one, but you can use it. Why? Because it's not a profession. Okay? So, I hope this is quite clear to you. You would have understood. But again and again I am saying, if you need a perfect calculation or a distance, so you need to choose for particular instruments for measuring. As a tailor, let's talk about a tailor. You would have been to a tailor shop when you have to stitch cloth for you. Even I go many a times when I have to stitch my dresses. So what the tailor will do, just he see me and just start stitching without having any accurate distinct measurement. No, I have to give him a proper measurement. If it will be improper or just by guess he makes, so I cannot have a proper fitting of my dress material. So when we move to tailor or to stitch something, it is necessary to have a proper measurement. Then only we can get a proper cloth, a proper dress to wear. This is how we talk about dress. Even proper measurement should be there for making homes better. If you do not put up proper beams downside when you have to construct a home or a house or a building, whatever, proper beams should be there provided. In earlier days there was nothing. People can live in mud houses. They make on their own. If something comes, this thing, earthquake come or whatever, immediately everything goes off. Not only that, if this thing air increases its space, then also there can be a harm. Even it can be broken by the animals too. Why? Because they don't have particular knowledge how to make. Nowadays, what is happening? There are the larger earthquakes coming, natural calamities like flood coming. So we need to make a proper strong houses. So that's why we always concern when we just make the buildings or homes or hospitals, we have to talk to architects, because they are the people who give us perfect number or perfect area, how to make, where to put the beams. They are the base of homes, and when we put on a proper spaces, so there will be no issue at all. As well as everything is important, not only the beams, how we have to build up a home, what type of cement we should use. It has a certain measurement. Without measurement, what will going to happen? The building is made up of concrete only. It can broken down also. There can be a crack. If we don't add proper amount of cement or a water, then only it can harm you. In what way? The building will demolish. So measurement is everywhere. Even measurement is done with you also. How you can measure the time, how you study, and if suppose you doesn't get the good mark, you can calculate on your own, because you have the measurement of time that I didn't study for even an hour. How can I get the good mark? So if we just see all around, so you will going to find measurement everywhere. As I talk all these things, so this, the measurement of hand is called hand span. The measurement of arm is called arm measurement. The measurement which we take by the help of our feet, it is called what? It is called the foot distance, and this wall is shoulder. Okay, shoulder to shoulder, and this is a particularly arm distance. We can say one arm, two arm. This is called the arm distance. I think this measurement is quite clear to you.